I shared a copy of my PowerPoint. If you'd like to follow along, that's what I'm going to be reading off of. And I've got a couple of like illustrations and stuff if you want to look at it. So I did my presentation on the birthing process and its complications. More specifically, I focused on postpartum hemorrhage. I was interested in the idea that the United States is so developed medically and technology-wise, yet so many women die during labor. So on the second slide, I've got a couple of graphs right here. And on the left, that information is from this year, 2021. And it basically just shows how the maternal deaths in the United States are, they keep going up, while even in places that are more underdeveloped, they seem to be going down. And then on the right, this information is from 2015, so it's a little bit older, but it shows that we are fifth out of all of these countries in maternal mortality. And so I was interested in trying to figure out why is that and what are we doing to change that. So with childbirth comes risks, and so the risks, they range from being mild and uncomfortable to severe and life-threatening. So some of the most common birthing complications are tears, perineal tears, labor that does not progress, abnormal heart rate of the baby, and then the mother's water breaking too early, which results in preterm labor. These examples are not typically linked to any severe birthing complications, and they're not directly linked to maternal mortality. So if these things happen, the mother is typically going to be okay. Postpartum hemorrhage. So postpartum hemorrhage is the leading cause of death out of any complication related to childbirth. Postpartum hemorrhage is when the mother experiences more blood loss than is normally associated with childbirth. A mother will generally lose half a liter of blood over the entire course of their labor. Anything more than that is classified as a postpartum hemorrhage, and then any blood loss that is over 1 liter is considered very significant and will be fatal if it's not replaced by a blood transfusion. Postpartum hemorrhage, a lot of the times it doesn't show signs, and it's very sudden, but if it does show signs, the signs are typically excessive or bright red bleeding, fundus, which is the top of the uterus, that does not respond to massage, and I will talk more about that in a little bit. Any abnormal clots, pelvic discomfort or back aches, persistent bleeding, an increased pulse or decreased blood pressure, hematoma formation, and then decreased level of consciousness. So like I said, hemorrhage, it doesn't normally show any signs or warnings or symptoms, and it can even occur in the healthiest of individuals. So it accounts for 25% of all maternal deaths worldwide and 12% of pregnancy-related deaths in the United States alone. So it is estimated that one woman dies from postpartum hemorrhage every 4 minutes, which means that 140,000 deaths every year come from hemorrhage. And there was a study by the CDC that said that 70% of hemorrhage-related deaths in laboring mothers can be preventable, which is really sad. So ways that we do prevent it is that healthcare professionals have a mnemonic that's called the four T's. And that's to determine the mother if the mother is actively losing too much blood. So it is tone, tissue, trauma, and thrombin. So placental abruption is it can be classified as a trauma. And so that is when the placenta separates. It can be either partially or completely from the uterine wall. So when the fetus first starts to develop, the placenta is formed and it attaches itself to the wall of the uterus. And when the placenta, when it detaches from the wall, it can cause profuse bleeding. And then thrombin is the body's coagulation factor. And these levels are tested to see how the mother's blood is clotting. So less thrombin means more bleeding. Uterine atony is the failure of the uterus to contract like it's supposed to following delivery, which can cause more bleeding than normal. So this is that first T in the four T's tone. So in the uterus, it can accumulate tissues and clots. And if it remains after delivery, it can interfere with the healing of the uterine wall. That's directly associated with uterine atony. So in order to to express the blood clots in the tissues, a fundal massage must be performed. And if you look on slide 7 on my PowerPoint, it shows how that's done to try to get the uterus to contract and to get that all those tissues out and everything. On slide 8, it talks about the frequency of those four T's. And so uterine atony is counts for 70% of postpartum hemorrhage. So the fundal massage is super, super important. Studies have also shown that the use of oxytocin, or some people know it as Pitocin, can be used to help prevent excessive bleeding. So Pitocin is normally used to get labor going that isn't progressing. So it causes the uterus to contract. And so that contraction after birth is what can help decrease the likelihood of the uterine atony that we were just talking about. Also, expecting mothers are checked for anemia through a blood test to help rule out any existing conditions that could affect their coagulation after delivery. And we can also do non-clinical preparation, something that we're not doing any tests, none of that, but just simply having your unit stocked and ready. They have things that are called hemorrhage carts on some OB floors, and it is stocked with everything they need in case a laboring mother does hemorrhage, and then also continuing education for healthcare professionals pertaining to postpartum hemorrhage through their learning management systems is very effective in keeping our healthcare workers educated on what to do. So, in conclusion, postpartum hemorrhage is the most prevalent cause of death in laboring mothers in the world, due to its ability to occur without warning signs or pre-existing conditions. Having medical staff that is educated, prepared, and ready is key to preventing and treating a condition that is very much avoidable.